News this morning, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has announced the House is in the process of drafting articles of impeachment. Take a listen.
The facts are uncontested. The president abused his power for his own personal political benefit at the expense of our national security by withholding military aid and crucial Oval Office meeting in exchange for an announcement of an investigation into his political rival.
We, of course, will be following this story closely to bring you the very latest information. And stay right here at 7 for more national coverage on this breaking news. And, of course, the announcement comes a day after four law professors testified before the House Judiciary Committee about the constitutional origins of impeachment. Three witnesses invited by the Democrats testified the president's attempts to pressure Ukraine are grounds for impeachment. The lone Republican witness argued Democrats have gotten ahead of themselves. The Judiciary Committee is expected to hold more public hearings. This morning, police are looking for a motive after an active-duty U.S. sailor opened fire on three civilian employees in Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, killing two before taking his own life. The attack happened at a shipyard just across from the Pearl Harbor National Memorial. Police are now trying to find out where the shooter got that gun. PG&E may be one step closer to reaching a settlement agreement with wildfire victims. Bloomberg News is reporting the utility is hammering out final details of a close to $13.5 billion payout to victims. The financial newspaper says PG&E would pay half in cash with a lump sum upfront payment and the rest in stock paid out over 18 months. The newspaper says no final agreement has been reached. Happening today, California's insurance commissioner will be taking up the issue of homeowner insurance and wildfires, citing the number of homeowner insurance non-renewals that are happening around the state. The commissioner is expected to announce a number of actions to help people find and keep their insurance. That meeting is today. It's in Oakland, but it will be live streamed on several social media platforms, and you can visit our website, actionnewsnow.com, to find a link to that information. A threatened lawsuit is bringing changes to Oroville voters. The City Council Tuesday approved district voting. What that means is that City Council candidates will now live in the district they campaigned for, and voters can only vote for candidates in their districts. The next step is for City Council to hire a demographer, and they will then evaluate the different ethnic breakdowns in the city to determine even representation throughout the city. Happening today, the Paradise Town Council will hold a news conference to provide updates on the town's recovery. Council members, disaster recovery managers, school officials, and the Paradise Irrigation District will all be at that conference. It is today at 2 p.m. at the Paradise Town Hall. And Caltrans is preparing to move forward on the second phase of safety improvements for Highway 70 south of Oroville. An open house is planned for next Wednesday so that the public can give input on that project. The plan calls for widening the highway between East Gridley Road and the Butte-Yuba County line. This $50 million project also calls for wider shoulders, turn lane improvements, and a new southbound bridge.